So today we are making my mama's famous meatloaf. And I have no idea what the ingredients are. How much ground beef did you put in there?
There's about 2.5 pounds of ground beef.
Yeah, what she said. 2.5 pounds of ground beef. Looks like some bell pepper.
Bell pepper. Minced bell pepper, minced garlic, minced onion.
And
Worcestershire.
And this
some Heinz 57.
I think ground black
some
pepper.
Some black pepper, some sea salt.
Oh, you're gonna also need some eggies.
Egg.
Breadcrumbs.
Breadcrumbs.
Mustard.
A little bit of mustard.
Mustard. And then we need vegetable oil.
Nope. No vegetable oil. Good. That's out because
okay,
I
okay, so this
the...
is like what it looks like right now. So my mom's now gonna put in. Let's see how this works. Go ahead, cook these, will ya? Ew, grossness.
Egg adds the
oh, you also... Do we need
salt? I already put granulated salt.
Oh, we also need sea salt.
Okay, messy part.
Oh, goodness. Okay, there we go. Look at all that grossness. Come on, I need to do one thing. This is my mom. She's making some dinner, some famous meatloaf.
Smells good too.
I know, it smells delicious, even though I have a stuffy nose.
I touched myself.
Do we also need this stuff?
I already put a little bit of garlic powder,
so
a little bit of onion powder.
And you're gonna need.
I used a little bit of that in there because it's got the onion seasoning that I like.
Grillmate Steakhouse onion burger stuff. And now you're gonna need some onion powder. And then you're just gonna put all that stuff together. You might want to check the green onions and the bell peppers, and then put them in the bowl with the ground beef, the 2 pounds of ground beef. Then you're gonna put the Worcestershire sauce, what is that sauce called?
The Heinz 57.
The Heinz 57 sauce and the mustard.
And blend it all together.
And blend it and
mix.
And then you're gonna put how many eggs did you put in there?
I put 2 eggs in there.
2 eggs.
Okay, you want to grab me a little bit of milk?
I'm going to go there. And then you're also going to need some milk.
A little bit of milk.
Yes, a little bit of milk.
Okay.
So our mother is just going to pour.
Put a splash of milk in there.
Put a splash.
There you go.
Put a splash of milk.
Because basically that adds some moisture.
2%. Oh, yes.
Okay.
And watch me while I put this away. You don't need any more milk, do you?
Nope.
Okay.
Smell.
And then also.
Smell.
Do you need.
I need breadcrumbs sprinkled in here.
Okay. We need the breadcrumbs sprinkled in this pan. Okay. Time for breadcrumbs sprinkling. Sprinkle.
Okay. That's enough for now.
Sprinkle.
Let me see how well that sticks together.
Sprinkles.
The breadcrumbs are just stick it together.
Na-na-na. Anyway. So yeah.
To make it a compact.
I guess we're still making this video.
Okay.
So you're
now that it's fully mixed.
Essential everyday breadcrumbs, Italian style. So yeah. So that's all you're gonna need, literally. And then also, what kind of pan do you need?
I'm gonna use a 9x13, but I gotta wash it first.
My mom's gonna use a 9x13 pan. But she kind of has to wash it first.
Ugh.
So while she's doing that, I'm going to be playing on a laptop computer. And by the way, I love Apple products. Yes! So right now I'm just listening to some tunes. Okay, tunes. Today, I got a tooth pulled today. I got a tooth there. to my other videos. So this is good. Getting it all set. But yeah. I don't like cheese grease. Oh, there's my body. Walking through the house. Yeah. So I'm going to change the radio to a different radio. So we'll be good. Oh, yeah. It's the Hannah Montana radio.
Maybe it's the things I say. Maybe I should think before I speak. But I thought that I knew enough. I know myself and knew what's right for me.
Yeah. And the walls I'm building through the house. Meatloaf in the pan. Yeah. And you might want to preheat the oven.
To 400.
To 400.
What you do is you make a loaf.
I'm not watching my mommy right now, so you may watch too. See, her phone is like an Apple product. See? Love Apple.
You're such a dork. And what you do is you make it into a loaf.
Loaf it up.
Pretty much.
So, yeah.
And then you cover it in tin foil and you put it in the oven for 25 to 30 minutes.
Yep.
Then uncover it, check it. Put whether you like ketchup or barbecue sauce, 167 balls on it, and
you can put basically put whatever you want on it. It doesn't matter. Bob,
you're such a dork. Bob, be mature, dork.
Bob, that's my mom, everybody. So yeah, so she's gonna cover it. Not there. But yeah, you just want to do that, and you make your meatloaf. Your loaf.
Meatloaf.
Okay, and then you want to put it in the nice and warm oven. And that's basically it. So yeah, you want to let that cook for 25 to 30 minutes, and then check it. And then if it still needs heating, you can either poke it with a stick.
Poke it with a stick.
Preferably a skewer, like this. A skewer. So yeah, a skewer, and you want to poke it with a stick. A skewer, preferably a skewer. And if it still needs more cooking, and it's still around the middle, bake it for, I have no idea how much longer. How much longer?
Another 15.
Another 15 to 20 minutes. And yes, my brother is now in the kitchen.
Well, dinner just went in the oven.
So, I will see you guys tomorrow on this channel.
You can't see it.